What's up, you guys? Bananda here. This video is going to be a story time. I don't think I've talked about this, but I might have, but probably not, like, in detail. This video is about how me and Chris met. Me and Chris met, if you didn't already know, we met at our job. Well, he doesn't work there anymore, but he used to work there. But he used to work there with me. I was going to school at the time. And around this time, I dropped out of regular high school and I went to diploma completion. If you don't know what diploma completion is, it's instead of going to regular high school, you pretty much sit at a table and do all your work online. You get more one-on-one attention with a teacher because you're in a classroom, or you could do this at home, but I did it in an actual, like, classroom. There's probably, like, 10 people in my class at a given time because you had from 8 a.m. till 5 to be there, and you only had to be there 4 hours each day. Had to add up to 20 hours each week, which is awesome for people that work jobs or just hate school in general, which that's how I felt. I could not go to school anymore. But I was doing that, and this opportunity came up for me to be able to go to this job. I got offered it because, my family is, like, low income and stuff like that, and there being a lot of us. So the teacher gave me this opportunity, was like, hey, there's this job, they would pay you to go to school, and you would get to go, you'd only have to work there on Fridays, and Fridays is when you pretty much get to go a whole bunch of places, or somebody comes in and does, like, it's kind of like a presentation kind of thing about what they do or whatever. And that's pretty much all that happens on Friday. So I was like, cool, awesome. I got the job. I went in on my first day there. At the time, I didn't have a car. I still don't have a car, but at the time, I didn't have a car. And I was still living with my parents. So my mom had to drive me to work on my first day. I was freaking out because, for one, at the time, I didn't think I knew anybody. I actually knew one person. Her name is Kiana. We used to hate each other because I dated this guy, and she's best friends with him. And then I broke up with him, and he said a whole bunch of dumb shit that wasn't true about me, and started a whole bunch of shit. So, she's gonna hate me. I'm gonna have a worse time at work. It's gonna be bad. Everyone's gonna make fun of me. Everyone's gonna dislike me because I was the binky girl. I was the girl with the pandas. My first day, Chris was actually parking his bike. I think he was running a little late whenever I showed up because I came a little bit later in the day. I can't remember if I got there in the morning or if I got there a little later, but I remember I was, like, almost late and I was freaking out because my mom makes me late for everything. And so he was parking his bike because at the time he didn't have a car. Well, his car didn't run. He had a car, but didn't run. And so he rode his bike to work every day. And he was parking his bike, he had his gold gauges in, his rose gold gauges that match his lip ring. And he has lip ring and a beanie on, and he just looked so cute, and I was like, oh. I think he was wearing his leather jacket. I can't remember exactly what he was wearing, but I remember that he looked so cute, and it was awesome. But, we met. And when me and my mom were driving past, she's like, you're gonna find someone and you're gonna date them. You're gonna, like, make friends. It's gonna be awesome. You're gonna be with someone. And I was super, super scared. Like, I didn't know. You can come in if you want, Chris. Oh, I guess he's downstairs. I thought it was someone else, but it must have been something. I don't know. But, my mom was like, this is really funny. My mom told me, she's like, yeah, you guys are gonna end up together, probably. Watch. Just watch. Because he was, like, technically my perfect type of a guy that I wanted to be with, because he had piercings and gauges and everything, and it was amazing, and I was like, oh. And I didn't know who he was. Like, I was so scared. And I was like, no, Mom, no, I'm not gonna find anybody. I'm gonna make no friends. I'm gonna be alone forever. I'm never gonna have anyone. I'm just gonna be, no one's gonna want to be friends with me. Like, ever. Nobody ever does. Because I just constantly doubt myself. And it looks like I have, like, two little ears because of my curls. But, past that. So, I go in, I'm like running inside, grabbing my apron, putting myself in my locker, like freaking out, not knowing what to do. So I get into work and I sit down and like he's like across the table with me. Like he's set, like, okay, there's this huge like rectangle table and I'm sitting like at the end and he's sitting, or I'm sitting at like the end by the door and like the food, because they serve us breakfast. Like, yeah, we get breakfast and then we get lunch, but they like serve us breakfast and it was like right next to the breakfast table. And then like across was like Chris, and then there was like Kiana, Jax, and all of them. And there was like another dude, I think his name is Donovan. And then there was like another, like, I think it was like two other people next to me, kind of. I was like by myself. And everyone else has been there for like weeks and weeks and weeks. So I'm like by myself, like I'm it. So in the mornings, after we have opening meeting, we do stress monitor and everything. Like, I don't remember what happened then, but we do cleanup and we clean the whole building. Each of us get like a chore or whatever. Mine at the time was to sweep the kitchen, the gallery, and sweep like the entryway where the front desk is. And so I did that and everything. And after we finish, we all like kind of chill out and get a drink of water, and then we just kind of walk around and wait for everyone to get done, or if anyone needs help, you go help them. So at the time, I didn't know anybody. I didn't know if anyone needed help. I didn't feel like talking to fucking anybody. Like, I didn't fucking know anybody. But I just kind of kept walking kind of around him because I wanted him to talk to me, but I was too scared to talk to him. And I kind of didn't want people to talk to me, but I really wanted to talk to Chris because I just, like, I wanted to talk about his gauges. If any of you guys ever meet me and you have gauges, the first question I'm going to ever ask you is, what size are your gauges? Because that's like one of my favorite things to ask. I love knowing what size people's gauges are and how they got that far and why they got that big or why they didn't get that big. I just like knowing that. I'm weird. I like that. But I asked him about that and I asked him about his tattoos. But I really want to talk to him, and he came up to me first. And if he would not have came up to me first, I probably would never have talked to him. Like, at all. I probably never would have. But he came up to me, and he complimented my hair. At the time, if you didn't know, I used to have purple hair in the beginning, like, the beginning of my videos. If you watched those, I had beautiful, beautiful purple hair. I'm getting purple hair back as soon as possible. I'm gonna try to dye my hair this Monday. Get hair dye this Monday. I want to dye my hair purple again. I want my purple locks back. I miss it. And when I get dreads, I want my purple fucking dreads. So he came up to me, complimented my hair. I think he complimented my eyes. Usually it's my hair and my eyes. Hey, Chris. Christopher. Do you remember what you said? What was, like, after you complimented my hair? Did you compliment my eyes? I can't remember. When we first met.
Yeah.
It was my hair and my eyes.
Because you said you like my gauges.
I asked you what size your gauges were, and I asked you about your tattoos. And, oh, that's the one you were in baseball?
Yeah.
You were number 0?
No. That stands for Oscar Losers, duh.
Oh, I didn't know.
Because I was an Oscar loser.
Okay, and so, after that, I think, like, we talked for, like, a little bit, and then he, like, found me on Facebook, and he, like, did you, like, stalk?
I, like, wanted to try to find you on Facebook, but I didn't have any fucking clue how to spell diamond.
Why? How do you not know how to spell diamond? It's D-I-A-M-O-N-D.
But then, like, the next day, I went to, like, work, and I saw your name tag on your, like, thing. I was like, sweet.
I'm gonna have so many people adding me on Facebook, watch, and then everyone's gonna know where I live. I won't add any, if you don't live where I live, I won't add you on Facebook. It's how it goes. If I don't fucking know you, that's how it is, like, and you don't even know, like, I might not even live in the place that I have set is where I live. Like, you don't know, because I move a lot. Like, the place that I was born is a lie on Facebook. I'm not a liar. I lied about where I was born. That's it on Facebook.
Candyland?
No, I said I was born in Las Vegas. I'll tell you later. Okay. but...
I was born here.
I wasn't born here.
I was born here.
I was not born in this state at all.
I was born in this town.
I was born in the state next to us. You know what I'm talking about? What? There's lots of states next to us. No, not that state. No. I wish. That'd be like the best story ever if I was born there. No, but he added me and like not even a few days later, we kind of got together.
Yeah, it was a few days later.
Yeah.
It was like, yeah, a few.
And then not even like, not even, how many months was it? I think it was like our 5 month or was our 3 month of anniversary when I moved in with you.
I think it was around 3 or 4.
It was like our 3 or 4 anniversary and I moved in with him. But before that, didn't your mom want me to move in with you anyway?
Yeah.
So that's kind of how our relationship kind of is. We moved very fast in our relationship.
Because we're ready to be done with all the bullshit of just like looking for someone. Like,
yeah.
I'm not fucking down for that whole like.
I'm not down with. Trying to, I'm not down to, and I don't like being in the dating world. I fucking hate it.
Me too.
That's why, if you know me, like, in general, if you've known me for a long time, or actually know me in person, you know that me and relation, or not being in relationships, I always, when I break up with somebody, it's not that I get with somebody super fast, it's more, I don't like not being in relationships, because it's just, everyone's gross dicks, and I don't feel like being into that. Like, everyone does have gross dicks. Everyone has gross genitalia, in my opinion. Genitalia in general is gross. But yeah, that's it. That's the story of how we met. If you didn't know that, there you go. If you knew that, well, now you know even more, maybe? I don't know. There's a few of you that probably had no idea. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I have a tiny thumb. Hi, poos. If you don't like this video, I'm sorry. Like, if you have any ideas for videos you want. No. If you don't like this video, then tell me a video you want to see, and I will try to make it happen. I'm thinking about making another... Mr. Fat Face. I'm thinking about making another video in a minute, if I can talk Chris into making it with me. It's the coloring one I wanted to do. Or we can do our Play-Doh one we've been talking about for like months. But if you're not subscribed, you should hit that subscribe button. If you are subscribed, but the thing is, and you don't have your notification thing in, you should probably do that as soon as possible, because if you haven't noticed, my uploading, when I upload, is so fucked up that if you're not have the bell notifications, you will never know when I upload a video. Like fucking ever. Like, sorry. And if you subscribe to me, I always subscribe back, so hit that subscribe button, because then you get another subscriber. But yeah, I love you guys. Pooza loves you too, even though he is an asshole and hates everything. Don't you hate everything? Except for head pets. He loves head pets. Oh, I was gonna show you guys this. Chris actually got me a new panda.
Holy fuck! That's a big ass panda.
He's my Christmas panda, even though it's not Christmas. He's huge as fuck. And he's so cute, and his paws are so adorable, and his name is Big Ben.
Who just got scared as fuck? He's still looking around. He's like, what the fuck was that?
His name is Big Ben, and if you didn't know, we have another Ben, and his name is Benjamin. He's a little dirty. He kind of has been out in the rain for the past few days, because I walk home and it's been raining, so yeah, and he's a little dirty, but this is Big Ben and Benjamin. This is Big Ben is Benjamin's dad, so yeah, that's it. More to my panda family. If you didn't know how many pandas I have, I think I have a video talking about my pandas. I don't know what video it is. It's like an old ass video with purple hair. Just look for the purple hair videos, and just watch all of those. You'll find it somewhere. I did a lot of creepy shit in those videos, just telling you.
Nunchucks.
I don't have nunchucks. You know how to use nunchucks. Bye, guys.